Okay, if you're joining us tonight, today for the first this morning for the first time, we are seeing Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and we have reached chapter 8. I'll chant some of the verses. The name also. Okay. Just to complete the whole thing, we are seeing one additional name of Puja Gurudev every day. So, I'll chant some names. You can repeat, and then we'll see one additional name of Puja Gurudev. Om Dhar Nishchayaya Namaha. Om Dharma Samsthapakaya Namaha. Te namaha.
Om Dhimate namaha.
Om Dhiraya namaha.
Om Dhiraya namaha.
Om Dhairya Pradaya namaha.
Om Dhairya Pradaya namaha.
Om Narayanaya namaha. Namaha.
Om Nijanandaya Namaha.
Om Nirapekshaya Namaha.
Om Nirapekshaya Namaha.
Om Nisprahaya Namaha.
Om Nisprahaya Namaha.
Om Nirupamaya Namaha. Nirupamaya namaha.
Om Nirupamaya namaha.
Nirupamaya namaha. Gurudev is called as Nirupama. Nirupama means, in Sanskrit, Upama means comparison. Comparison. And I told you previously what Nir means. Nir means without. So Nirupama will be what? Without comparison. And the other way to say that in English is incomparable. Incomparable. You cannot find anything to compare Puja Gurudev to. If you say Puja Gurudev is a good linguist, your description will fall way beneath that. Because a linguist, he has to really study for a long time and go on practicing. He said Gurudev didn't have to study. Mother Saraswati herself used to give him words. Like that. How you'll compare to a linguist? Incomparable. Nirupamaya namaha. In every regard, what an orator. What a jnani. What a mahatma, sage. Who you'll compare him to? Incomparable, he's called. Nirupamaya namaha. What a nice name it is. And if you have to, if you have to be compared to something, at least compared to something good. We compare ourselves to all sorts of crazy things. So Nirupamaya namaha. Alright. So yesterday, when we left it, we were seeing now, I told you, chapter 8, and we are dealing with this topic of time, because chapter 8 deals with death, and I told time and death, they are one and same. Because every second, every minute that goes away, we are dying. We are dying, We are not getting younger. Every minute that goes away, dying away. Everything else in the world also, not only human beings, but everything else. So time topic came up. And as that topic came up, it also now speaks about time of death. And I told you, it is a very symbolic, metaphorical part of Gita. We'll chant some of these verses. Because people ask, about right time to die, and I answered many of those questions last night about is there untimely death, and then there is no such thing as untimely death. When a person dies, that is the time. Untimely death and all that has to be understood properly. Untimely means you are supposed to live for so many years, but you live such a bad life that you get bad karma, and at a certain age, why is it bad karma? It's because I didn't have enough years to practice sadhana. That is all. I'm supposed to have maximum number of years to practice sadhana. Also, not only living for 100 years, but living for 100 years in good mind. There are many people who live for 100 years, but after a certain age, nothing is there. So recently, I met a man at one place. He said, "Bet, what is your name?" So I tell him my name. He walked from here to this post, this pillar right here, this distance he walked. And he turned around and he came back. And he looked at me again, as though he seen me for the first time. He said, "Bet, what is your name?" Now, he lived long, He lived for a long time, but... So not only living long, living for the full 100 years, but living in good mental health, yes, is important. So that I can remember God. I can do more sadhana. Otherwise, no sense living that all that age and all. What you'll do? If a person is living that all that age and not doing any sadhana, what? Spiritual practice, alright? Now, when a person dies, this topic about time of death, it will come again later on in the 18th chapter. But here, Bhagwan deals with it in a very symbolic, metaphorical sort of fashion. Now see this thing. This is verse number 24. 23, 24 we'll chant. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Tim Chai Bhai Yogi. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. The best way to understand these verses is to start from the last one first. The last one we chanted. Listen to Bhagavan's words. This is verse number 26. It says, Shukla Krishna Gati Hete Jagata Shashwate Mate. That in this Jagat, in this world, there is Shukla and Krishna. Shukla means white, literally. This is literally what I'm telling you first. Shukla means white, Krishna means dark. So bright and dark, let us say like that. Shukla and Krishna. It says, Shashwate Mate. That this is the eternal cycle of the universe. Between bright and dark. I mean, you see, you have what you call daylight and night. Then you have bright fortnight and dark fortnight. Then you have positive and negative. You have good and bad. You have knowledge and ignorance. This is the whole world is made up like this, right? And this is eternal. This has been like that from ever since. Then he says, Ekala Yati Avrittim Anya Avartate Punaha. That when a person dies, in one of them, see this, what he's talking about is the pair of opposite, right? When he dies in one of them, he returns. When he dies in the other one, he doesn't return. But which one now? When he dies in the condition of his mind is being spoken about. When the condition of his mind is one of them, he returns. And when it is the other one, he doesn't return to this world. Please remember, the goal in Hinduism is not to return to this world. Eh? The goal in Hinduism is to merge with God. So, when he dies with the condition of his mind in Shukla, he doesn't return. When he dies with the condition of his mind in Krishna, he returns. That means what? Simple thing. If the condition of my mind is pure knowledge, just now I told you knowledge and ignorance. If I die with knowledge in my mind, then I don't return. If I die with ignorance in my mind, I return. That is all. It's a simple thing. A person who dies in full awareness, full consciousness, full knowledge, he merges with God. There is no returning to this world. If I die with any bit of ignorance in my mind, there is no full knowledge, then I return. If there is a lot of knowledge but not full knowledge, I may be born in the house of a rishi, born in the house of a sage, saint, something like that, right? I may get a good birth, but I still return. There is still returning to this world. So, any death without full knowledge, there is return. It may be good return also, like I said just now, but still there is return. And in fact, to say good return, that also is not a good thing. There is no such thing as a good return. Because even if I am born in the house of a sage, still I will have to go through so many suffering. Because you know that, no matter which house you are born in, suffering is there or not. See, Rama is born in the house of Dasharatha Ji Maharaj, right? He's born in the house of a king. And how much suffering, big man like he crying in the forest. In Trinidad language you say like that, huh? How he also has to go through suffering. And when time to eat, Dasharatha Ji Maharaj says, come, time to eat. Because no children are like when their parents discipline them, isn't it? He want to play. And the father and mother saying, come on, eat. Come on, do this. Come on, do that. Make up your bed. Polish your shoe. No, no, I don't like polish your shoe, one thing. Children don't like. The exact thing with children don't like. See, like one child was saying. He said, I don't know what's wrong with these parents. They don't know anything about parenting. In the night time when I don't want to sleep, they tell me, go and sleep. In the morning time when I want to sleep, they say, get up. So, now see, that is correct parenting, eh? But the child doesn't know that, so he's suffering. Isn't it? So, from all childhood, everything is all suffering only. And you get this pain, this disease, this sickness, all, and then only suffering. So, even if I have a good birth in the house of a rishi, that doesn't exclude me from any suffering. Still, misery, wherever it is. So, the one who has only full knowledge, he is now figuratively here now. It says, now see these verses. These are two verses. We say, अग्ने ज्योतिरः शुक्लः षण्मासः उत्तरायणम् यत्र प्रयाता गच्छन्ति ब्रह्म ब्रह्मविदो जनाः दैट द पर्सन हु डाइज गच्छन्ति मीन दोस पीपल हु गो गच्छन्ति दे गो इन व्हिच टाइम अग्निः ज्योतिः शुक्लः षण्मासः उत्तरायणम् व्हाट आर ऑल दीज वर्ड्स It means he dies. Agni means fire. Now see, how you die in fire? That's why I told you this all thing is figurative. Oh. You see, them fellas and I'm used to setting up for calm environment. That will keep falling down. Good now? Yeah. Now I talk behind Gurudev back. Right. So, a person who dies in Agni, a person who dies in Jyoti, light. Agni means fire. Jyoti means light. A person who dies in Ahaha means daytime. A person who dies in Shukla means in the bright fortnight. A person who dies in Shanmasa Uttarayanam, in the northern solstice of the sun. You know there are six months when the sun is moving? North. And another 6 months is moving? South. So what this verse is saying, I'll show you how it has to be nothing but figurative. Look here. He dies in Agni fire, he dies in Jyoti, light, he dies in daytime, he dies in Shukla, in the bright fortnight, or he dies in Uttarayanam, right? He says here, Yatra Prayata Gacchanti, Brahma Brahmavido Janaha. That person goes to that state where there is no return. This person. But look here. Study the last one, the 6 months of the Northern Solstice. Right? So if he dies in that 6 months of the Northern Solstice, when the sun is moving north, in that 6 months, there is also Krishna and Shukla Paksha, mean dark fortnight and bright fortnight or not. So if he dies when this sun is going not for 6 months, in that 6 months if he dies, but in the dark fortnight. Well, he satisfied one, but he didn't satisfy the other one, isn't it? It means he died in the right 6 months, but he didn't die in the right 2 weeks. Because 2 weeks will be dark and 2 weeks will be bright. So, in this way we understand, but I died in the right 6 months, but I didn't die in the right 2 weeks. And suppose, you live on a week now. Suppose you take the week now. He died in the bright 2 weeks, right? But, he died in the night time now. Then what happened to him now? So the idea here is the mind is what, and this will come later on. I told you in chapter 18, death only has to do with the condition, means where I will go and where I will not go, has only to do with the condition of the mind. So the Agni, Jyoti, daytime, bright fortnight, Uttarayanam, they signify the condition of the mind, means the mind in a sattvic mode, the mind in an enlightened mode, the mind in a bright mode, aware mode, and this is the most important mode. You have to remember this. The mind at the time of death should be fully aware. This is the whole thing. If this mind, like people just die in sleep, I told you on previous day, na? People just die in sleep, they die unconscious, in a coma, all that kind of thing. That is sure return. That is sure return to this world. Sages, saints, rishis and all die in full awareness. Those are the ones who don't return. So that full awareness is signified here, or metaphorically spoken here, as light, as daytime, as bright fortnight, as Uttarayanam, all that kind of thing. So
that is what is being spoken about, and not the literal, if you die in daytime, then you get moksha. If you die in nighttime, well, your dog's dead. Not like that. You can't take it literally like that.
Yeah.
So, and then now the other verse is the reverse. It now here, dhuma means smoke. Means if you die with your mind clouded. Many people, you know, see, as the doctors were sitting here, right? When somebody come into the hospital, they'll ask them, you know, when they looking delirious and they're looking like they're out of it, and they'll ask them, you know, the day today? What is the question always ask? The date and time, where your day and thing, eh? Time, place, and put, yeah, you know. They'll ask, you know the time, you know? Let me tell you the truth, how I know this. One day I go in San Fernando Hospital to see some patient. So one lady come in there, she drank Clorox bleach. She drank Clorox, but she wanted to commit suicide. So she drank Clorox bleach. So the doctor started to ask all this question. I standing right there. Man, she answered all them questions correct. Even I didn't know the day and the time and all that kind of thing. I say, what? I should go and drink some bleach, boy? She answered everything. But see, that is the time when you go there and you're looking and asking. Now, people who die not knowing any of this thing, that means dhuma, smoke, his mind. Smoky. Smoky means what? Clouded. The mind. So, smoke, dhuma, ratris, ratri means night. Means the mind is full of ignorance. Because you know, we say the darkness of ignorance and the light of knowledge. So, if he dies like this, ratri, tatha krishnaha, in the dark fortnight, all of these things symbolize ignorance in the mind, cloudiness in the mind, the absence of knowledge in the mind, like that. So, if he dies like that, then he goes to a different path of return. That is the idea. Nivartate means returns, he comes back. So, one has to make sure that throughout one's lifetime, so what is being actually indicated, throughout the lifetime, stay in satsang and stay studying shastras and keep the mind alert, aware, bright all the time, studying the reality, God, that kind of thing. We should not leave this world in that kind of, what do you call, dreary kind of gloomy mind, with that devoid of knowledge. Smoky, clouded, confused, all that kind of thing, you see? So he says, these are these two parts. So Shukla Krishna Gati Hete Jagataha Shashvate Mate. These are eternally, they are there, and people, some die like this, the majority die actually, like the last one, eh? Majority die with. See, one more thing about this chapter, you know. This chapter is very blunt and to the point. It's not going to soften, it's not going to make anything soft for us. It is telling exactly what the truth is, yeah. You can't make anything soft. Very, very blunt and straightforward. These are the two parts, and most people die in the latter one. Means we die with our mind not having any knowledge of God. We die with so much ignorance in the mind. We die with so much of unawareness. Actually, this is the word you should remember. Unawareness. Unawareness of reality and God and all that. So, in one, ekaya, yati anavrittim, in one of them, the first one, there's no return. He dies with full knowledge, full awareness. No return. Anavrittim, no coming back. Then, anya, the other one, vartate punaha, he comes back again. That means that he didn't fulfill his human birth, because we are supposed to live in such a way that we don't come back. You see? Bhagavan continues now, see.
Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Jai Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Nete Sriti Arth Janan Yoga.
iti partha janan yogi muhyati kashchana. That the person who dies with this full awareness, who dies with this full awareness, that yogi, that great sage, that mahatma, that saint, namuhyati, he doesn't become deluded anymore. The smart sat therefore means he doesn't fall into this delusion anymore. The delusion in which we are living. The smart, therefore, sarveshu kaleshu yoga yukto bhava Arjuna. Therefore, O Arjuna, at all times, remain yoga yuktaha. Yoga yuktaha means in a state of yoga, it means mind united with God. That is the idea. Yoga yuktaha. Stay with the mind united in God. It means let the mind be thinking about God all the time. Otherwise, our mind only thinking about all worldly things. One worldly thing after the next. And so we will die. We saw that now in this chapter 7. Devan, Yajo, Yanti Devan. Those who worship the Devas go to Devas. Mad Bhakta, Yanti Mamapi. My devotees come to me. So if the one is thinking about God all the time, and he dies like that thinking about God, he'll go to God. And the one who is thinking about the world all the time, and he dies like that, where he'll go? World. This is the idea. It all has hinges on what we are thinking of, what we are sadhata bhava bhavitaha, what we are preoccupied with in our heart, in our mind all the time. So we should be preoccupied with God. And please remember, we are not talking about leaving home and going and staying in temples and ashrams and that. We are not talking about that. Eh? Preoccupied with God means anything I see in the world, I should see the divinity in the thing rather than just see the thing, the material aspect of the thing. Everything is pervaded by divinity. That I should see. I mean, it's hard to see divinity in that, but I mean. And the last verse changes the meter. Chanda changes in this last verse. This will. No need for this. We have worked it out yet. Vedeshu yagneshu tapasu chaiva. Daneshu yatpunya phalam pradishtam.
Daneshu yatpunya phalam pradishtam.
Atyeti tat sarvamidam viditva.
Atyeti tat sarvamidam viditva.
Yogi param sthanam upaiti chadyam.
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 Vedeshu, in all the Vedas, Yagneshu, in all Yagnas, tapasu, in all austerity and tapas which we do, it means all sorts of austerities and worship and all sorts of spiritual practices and all that we do, daneshu, whatever dan we give, you know, these are things that we do, spiritual practices, right? So Vedeshu means all the study of the Vedas, all yajna, all whatever we are doing, all dana that we are giving, yat punya phalam pradishtam, what all punya we get from all, punya means, punya is the opposite of pap, pap means sin. So when we do bad thing, we get pap. When we do good thing, we get punya. This. Now you can't translate punya in English, you know. It's a very hard thing. Or you say punya. Merit, it is translated as merit, right? But punya is much more than that. And pap is much more than sin also. Those Sanskrit words are very difficult to translate in English. So whatever punya we get from doing, giving dan. Dan means charity, giving donation, this whatever punya we get, whatever punya we get from doing tapas, spiritual practice, whatever punya we get from doing yajna, whatever punya we get from studying of the Vedas, chanting of Vedic mantras, just now they were chanting there, over there, and that Rudramano, and Pandit was chanting so many Vedic mantras and all there. So all these mantras and all, whatever punya we get from them, atyeti tat sarvam idam viditva. Having known this reality, that person goes to, let me back up there a little bit. In all of those punya that we get from doing all of these good deeds, they all help in this person reaching his goal. That is first thing. Second thing, those punya alone cannot take us to God. That they help, but they alone cannot take us there. What we have to do? We have to come to know this God, this absolute reality, who is pervading the whole world. Only then, yogi param sthanam upaiti cha adyam. That person reaches that supreme state only when he comes to know that reality also. Giving dana and all, you can't buy God. You can't buy God. And you have a yajna and you feed the whole world in your yajna, still that will not take you to God. You can feed as much people as you want, but that will not take you to God. Knowledge of God is absolutely important. Now those things will help us to get knowledge. It will purify the mind also, and the mind will be able to really hold the knowledge of God and all that. So the knowledge of God is very, very important. Therefore, atyeti tat sarvamidam viditva. Having known this reality, which is there all pervasive in the whole universe, that person, sthanam upaiti, param sthanam upaiti, goes to that supreme state. This brings us to the end of the 8th chapter. And the idea is how he started with death and all and ended up with something else. He didn't end up with something else. The idea is, if I'm going to die, this is how I should die. Not if I'm going to die, but when we are going to die. This is how we should die. What? Knowing God. And if we die like that, there is no return. Then I have fulfilled the whole purpose of life. Otherwise, some people feel the purpose of life is what? To eat, drink, and be merry. Only when he come back, then he know the next time. How much misery is there in this life, one after the next? Now comes chapter 9. Now I don't have any watch here, so I don't know when I started and when to stop. Okay. So, chapter 9, Navamaha Adhyayaha. We'll see this. Shri Bhagavan Vachari, Lord Himself. Now see, Arjuna did not ask any question. So Bhagavan talks all by himself. As though, you know, he likes to talk. Bhagavan doesn't like to talk, Yes. I'll tell you why the Lord talks. You know, if you see a child going to fall over the precipice, or you see some child, now the tide rising there, right? Therefore, we should tell Baba to go and immerse the Shiva Lingam fast before the tide rises too high. If you see a tide rising and see a child walking right on the edge there, you have to wait for somebody to tell her to go and save the child. No, you don't have to wait. In the very same way, Bhagavan sees all of us like that. He doesn't have to wait for somebody to ask him what is the proper thing to do and what is the improper thing to do, you know. Bhagavan knows this human being is blind like a bat. So he has to tell without being asked. You see? So he speaks by himself now, see. Shri Bhagavan Vacha. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama.
Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama.
Shri Krishna Sharanam.
Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama. Shri Krishna
भगवान से इदं तु ते गुह्यतमं प्रवक्ष्यामि अनसूयवे ओ अनसूयवे दिस इज़ अ नेम फॉर अर्जुन अनसूया अर्जुन आई टोल्ड यू हैज मेनी नेम्स इन दिस गीता वन ऑफ हिज नेम इज अनसूया अनसूया मींस वन हु डजंट कंप्लेन एंड क्रिटिसाइज वन डजंट कंप्लेन एंड क्रिटिसाइज इज कॉल्ड अनसूया So Bhagavan says, Oh Anasuya, Arjuna, I am going to tell you a supreme secret. Supreme secret. What is the supreme secret? Jnana Vijnana Saitam, along with knowledge and wisdom, which he already told in 7th chapter, you know. But he told in different words. He's going to have to tell the same thing again in different words. Because students are like that. Every student is... Some students you tell... There is, in the back, some pani, go bring it. Well, he doesn't understand what is pani. You tell some agua, he doesn't understand agua. You tell some water, he doesn't understand what is water. You tell in the back, they have some jal, ganga jal, from Blanchishes. He understands jal. So jal, pani, agua, whatever, you know, water. But different people understand differently, isn't it? So he tells, I'm going to tell you knowledge and wisdom again. My dear Arjuna, yes, jnatva moksha se shubha. Having known which, you will get moksha immediately. Or easily also. So, just now, the last chapter ended with getting moksha, isn't it? We are supposed to live a life in such a way that we get moksha, so when we die, we don't have to come back. So again, this picks up this topic of moksha. And few places in this Gita, directly the Lord mentions the word moksha. That is our goal. Eh? He said, this knowledge which I am going to give you is Raja Vidya, is the king of all knowledges. The king knowledge. King of all knowledge. It is Raja Guhyam, supreme secret. You know, if you go and tell somebody, look, I want to tell you something ordinary and common. Well, he want to listen to that. If you tell him, I want to tell you a supreme secret. If you go and tell him the most nonsense thing also, and you tell him, I want to tell you a supreme secret, he ready to listen. Isn't it? Bhagavan is very good at this. So he's going to tell the supreme secret of the universe. This knowledge, this supreme knowledge is a supreme secret. Not that Bhagavan is hidden it from us. Eh? It's not that Bhagavan is hidden it from us. It's Bhagavan has manifested this universe so attractive that we get so consumed by the universe that knowledge becomes hidden all by itself. Without trying to hide itself, the knowledge of reality, knowledge of the absolute becomes hidden because I am so taken up with the world. My mind is so consumed by this world that the thing which is right there, you know that in your ordinary life, I tell you, you will see. Look here. Sometimes you are looking for something also, but your mind is so preoccupied, that thing is right in front of you and you can see. You know what I'm talking about? Right in front of your eye. But your mind is so consumed by something else, that thing right here and you're not seeing it. So this is the idea. That's why it's a secret. Rajaguhyam, Pavitram Idam Uttamam, is supreme purifier. This knowledge purifies us of all our sins, it removes all our sins forever, on all karma and all. Supreme purifier. Pratyakshavagamam dharmyam susukham kartum avyayam. It is, I'm going to make it manifest right before you. I'm going to make this knowledge manifest itself right before you. This supreme dharma. This is dharma. I mean, it is good for you and good for the whole world also. That which is good is dharma. And susukham kartum avyam, easy of attainment. Easy of knowing this reality. Eh? That is the idea. I'm going to tell you, he says, Ashrata dhana, one who doesn't have purushaha, those people who don't have faith in this thing, dharma syasya oparantapa, this dharma is, which I'm going to tell you, this knowledge which I'm going to give you, aprapya mam nivartante mrityu samsara vartmani. They don't have faith in this, they don't learn it, they don't get moksha, and then they come back to this world. That is the idea. So what is the knowledge which Bhagavan is going to tell? That knowledge starts from the next. Actually, that whole knowledge is given in two verses. This chapter has 34 verses, eh? Something like that. But the whole knowledge is given only in two verses. The three verses which we just saw, that is introduction. He's only saying, I'm going to give. This knowledge. So he hasn't given anything yet. He just says the person who doesn't have Shraddha, faith in this, then he doesn't study it. When he doesn't study it, he doesn't get it, doesn't get moksha. Doesn't get moksha, he comes back to this world. But which knowledge you're talking about? That knowledge we'll see tomorrow.